hold on. I know what you're thinking. And I know how badly you want to go down in those comments and hand my ass to me. But this is not exactly what you think. Kinda. Okay, consider this my review of Cedar Point. I don't have a script. I don't know what the hell I'm about to say or where I'm gonna go with this, but we're just gonna go with it. So I've been to Cedar Point like what? 5 times now, and Cedar Point is an interesting park. I'm just gonna be bouncing around everywhere and telling you guys what I found weird about it and why it just surprised me. And honestly, I think this surprised me because all of my life, I've been told, oh my God, Cedar Point is the roller coaster capital of the world. Oh my God, Cedar Point is the greatest of all time. You've gotta go. Cedar Point. When you hear that name, well, when a Thuzy hears that name, they go berserk. It's a very interesting place, and let's start out with the roller coasters. Okay, MILF. Millennium Force is one of the most dog shit rides I've ever been on. I always try and find the good in a ride, even if I just don't like it. But Millennium, oh my God. There really are no redeeming qualities for this ride. I mean, yeah, there's a speed hill, which is okay. Even the drop was kind of bad. Everyone always talked about how the drop is just so on par with all the other Gigas, and I just don't see that at all. I mean, yeah, you've got the view, it's cool. I guess. I get it, it's fast. You know, I get why some people like it, and if someone does like it, I understand to a certain extent. But for me, you guys probably saw that wasn't even on my top 25. Millennium Force is just such a mediocre ride. I also understand that for its time, Millennium Force was groundbreaking. You know, I get it. It's a Giga. It was the first Giga. For its time, I see why people liked it. But that ride sucks. Okay, let's talk about another ride that I found either overrated or just poo. Huh. Every B&M there that isn't Raptor. Okay, Valraven, I'm not even gonna go into this very long. Valraven is just, what the hell? Gatekeeper. It's cool. It's got a cool drop. If you're in the back. It's very pleasing to the eye. I noticed that about a lot of rides at Cedar Point. They're very pleasing to the eye. And I wanna go over this real quick too. When you're driving up, going through the causeway, it's incredible. That is almost my favorite part about Cedar Point, is just driving up to it. It's amazing. I've never seen such a visually stunning anything in my life. That is such an exciting feeling. When you like drive up that causeway and you see all these roller coasters, it's a roller coaster metropolis. It doesn't get much better than that. I told you I'm gonna be all over the place, I'm sorry. Anyways, Gatekeeper is cool. And it looks good. Yeah, Rougarou. That's an interesting one. Rougarou, I have a love-hate relationship with that thing because there's been days, and I've only ridden this thing like 3 times, there's been days where I enjoyed it to a certain extent, and then there's been days where I was just like, that was dumb. So now we've gotten the B&Ms out of the way. What's another coaster there that I just don't like? I guess we can talk about the ones that your average person would call poo. Corkscrew. It's there. Iron Dragon. It's also there. Cedar Creek Mine Ride. Look, I understand why people like this roller coaster collection. I don't think it's bad by any means. I think it's good. Wicked Twister. I rode that once. I rode Wicked Twister before they, you know. Wicked Twister was pretty good. I enjoyed it. I actually really enjoyed it. But it's gone now, so the hell's the point? Gemini. That's a weird ride. I've ridden both sides. Gemini is kind of cool. Okay, I think we've gotten most of the coasters that I don't really mess with there out of the way. Let's talk about the big five.
Several months later.
Okay, so this is me from the future. I feel ashamed that I forgot to talk about this thing, Blue Streak. That ride is so good. I just didn't see it coming. I mean, seriously, it's got really good airtime. It's fun. I mean, if you get room, there's one of the most underrated wooden coasters I have ever ridden.
This nigga really think he's Bruce Lee.
You saw all of these, if you watched my top 25, you saw all of these on my list. Steel Vengeance, Maverick, Magnum, Dragster, and Raptor. Raptor is really the only B&M there that wowed me. I freaking love Raptor. That is my favorite invert. Raptor is just so intense. You really can't go wrong with it. There's not a single bad moment on that ride. And I know some people have complained about the headbanging, and I really don't, but I see what they're talking about and what part of the ride they're talking about. Dragster, I only rode it once. It was in row 5, absolutely incredible. I do not care what the people say about, you know, Dragster being a front row ride only. Are you kidding me? You're launching 120 miles per hour. Magnum. I rode it a couple of times last year and I wasn't a huge fan of it. It was pretty good, but I got a ride this year in the Magic Seat. Oh my God. That thing is a beast. Maverick is great, amazing ride, really nothing wrong with it. And Steel Vengeance is self-explanatory. It's still not better than I-305, but it's very close. I actually think Steel Vengeance is probably the most well-rounded ride I've ever ridden. There's not really a single bad moment on that coaster. I went there a day last year with me and my bro Matthew. We rode it about 3 times in a row at sunset. Yes, I'm not joking you. That line was ghosted. And that was just incredible. It was running the best I had ever ridden it. Up until the last time I went. Because, oh my God, the day I went, what, a week or two ago? 3 weeks ago? I don't even remember. Oh man. Everything was running great that day. So, that's pretty much all I have to say for the roller coasters. Yeah, that's all I got. Decent lineup. The top 5 there are great. Some of my favorite rides I've ridden. Everything below that. This is just brutal honesty. I know I'm gonna get my ass ripped in 2 for this one, but I don't care. I don't care. You know why? Because this was probably the most overhyped park I'd ever been to. And I felt like that was coming. I kind of saw it coming because of the fact that Cedar Point is, you know, the park that everyone goes to and they're like, holy shit, that was heaven on earth. And I kind of went in there somewhat thinking that. I didn't have my expectations like super duper high. They were high and it was really good. Cedar Point's a good park. In fact, it's probably in the top 5, maybe top 3 parks I've been to, and I've been to over 20 parks, so that should tell you something. It's a very good park. I love it. I'm always gonna go there. Obviously, I'm moving to Ohio soon, so why wouldn't I? And you can't not say it's a good park when it's the most visually stunning amusement park probably in the world, at least America. So, we got all the coasters out the way. Let's talk about something else. There is something truly off about this park. This is the one thing that I think made me want to make this video. And that one thing is something that I don't know. Yes, I really can't figure out what it is. I'm being serious right now. Maybe it's something that's missing. It could be the atmosphere. I don't know. Something didn't feel right, and it never feels right when I go there. It's not something so bad to the point where I'm not gonna go there. It could be the atmosphere though. Something felt weird about the atmosphere. It wasn't as incredible or exciting as I thought. And I know it's an amusement park. It's not supposed to be a theme park. Theme parks are great, but I'm really actually more of an amusement park guy. I think theming is good. I think it's cool to look at. If it's really good, then it's really cool to look at, but roller coasters, they're my thing. That's just me. it honestly could just be part of the fact that it was so overhyped for me. Again, I really like the park, and every time I go, it's good. It's a pretty good time. It's actually a really good time. You can't not have fun at this park. I think that's impossible. Actually, that's bullshit. Oh man, let me tell you, if you get crazy crowds, there goes your day. I guess things are cool to look at if you get crazy crowds, but it's like, eh. Now, I want to touch on something real quick. There were a lot of people back in the day, and people still say this, you really don't need more than one day at this park. Okay, 2 days is fine. But if there's no crowds, one day is cool. Like, I'm sorry. I went on a mildly crowded day, and I got like 75% of the stuff knocked out. And that's including rerides on some of the best. Like that day, I had done Maverick twice, I think. Steel Vengeance once. I think we rode Magnum a few times, so. And then add all of the other coasters I did. Like I said, I got like 75% done in a day that was fairly crowded. You really don't need to spend a week at this park. So, that's gonna do it for this video. Yeah, I have a feeling I'm about to get my ass ripped apart. But I really don't care. Hey, better real than fake, right? Anyways, that's gonna be all for today. I don't really have anything else to say. Bars.